Welcome to Punarvasi Technologies. I am Mr. Raj, SAP Basis International Trainer. Train students in 55 countries. Punarvasi.com is my website. I am writing different types of articles on SAP Basis Administration. With these articles, you will be benefited for learning SAP Basis Administration. In this video, for continuation of my earlier video, that is installing Windows Server 2008 X64, that is 64-bit operating system, for installing ECC 6.0 EHP 6 IDS software. Now, I am going to show you how to do the prerequisite installations, that is installing J2 SDK and then Oracle software and configuring environment variables in this video. Just I am connecting to my computer, another computer. In this computer, Windows 7 is host operating system. I hope you have seen my earlier videos. Same system I am using for this experiment. Okay, here for installation of prerequisites, that is J2 SDK and Oracle software, you need to have installation files. So this is fresh installation. As of now, there are no installation files available in this particular system. Just what I did is, I have created another virtual disk and I have copied all the required installation files onto that virtual disk. Now I am going to connect that virtual disk from the system. So just observe how I am connecting. Just go to VM and click on the settings button. And here only one hard drive is available that we have selected while installation of Windows Server 2008. Now I am going to add another virtual disk by clicking on the add button, and I am choosing this hard disk. Just click next and create a new virtual disk. Instead of new virtual disk, just you have to select use an existing virtual disk. You can also plan for that this type of configuration so that again and again you can avoid copying the installation files when you do experiments. Use an existing virtual disk, click on the next button, click on the browse, and I have stored all the files in this VMDK file, that is NW70DUMP. Double click on this and click on the finish button. Click on the OK button. Just click on the start and go to computer so that you should be able to view this new volume E drive. Okay, here all the files are located. That is ERP EHP 6, and here the installation export folder is there, and installation master folder is there, and we need to have J2 SDK folder, so that is available in this folder. Okay, this is the J2 SDK file, installation file. Just double click on this to start the installation of J2 SDK. First time you will get this message, just click on the OK button and again double click on it. I accept the terms in the license agreement, click on the next. And this is the folder, that is C:/J2SDK1.4.2_22-X64. Click on the next button. Click on finish. Okay, with this step, you should be able to find that related folder inside C drive. So this is the folder, just double click on it and right click on this folder and click on the copy address so that that C:/so-and-so folder will be copied to the clipboard. Just right click on computer, click on the properties and go to advanced system settings and click on the environment variables. And here in the user variables for administrator, click on the new button. You have to set the Java home, Java_home and Control V, that is whatever the folder we have copied and stored it in the clipboard, mouse clipboard, that will be pasted here. Click on the OK button. And in the system variables, just type P in your keyboard so that it will be stopped at path. Click on the edit button and click here and hit home button from your keyboard so that the cursor will be stopped at the starting point of this variable value. Just Control V again so that the /JTOSDK folder will be pasted, and put slash here and type bin and put semicolon. And this is setting of environment variables of J2SDK. Just click on the OK button. Now you can test the J2SDK by going to command prompt. Okay, here Java execute, and you should be able to see this information without any error. If it is giving this information, that means your installation is perfect. And also Java compiler can be executed like this, Java C, and it should give the help like this. And also you can check the version of the Java, Java hyphen version, hit enter. And this is Java version is 1.4.2_22 revision. Okay, so that Java is installed and perfectly working fine. Now this is the time for installing other prerequisite, that is database RDBMS software installation. And for installing ECC 6.0 EHP6, you need to install Oracle 11g software. Okay, now let us continue the installation of Oracle 11g. So just to make the screen little bit bigger, just I am entering Control Alt Enter from my keyboard. Yes, this is the server operating system. It is displaying in full screen. Just click on the computer and go to E drive, and here Oracle 11g software. So this is the folder, database and SAP folder. Double click on Windows command file. It is Windows command file. Okay, just double click on it and accept the default C:, so that the Oracle software will be installed in the C drive. And you should provide the SID, system identifier, for Oracle Home. Just you can provide any 3-character string, that is like this E6D, means you should use first character as letter, and second one and third one maybe letter or number. Okay, just hit enter so that the Oracle Universal Installer will be started in few seconds. So this is the initial screen. From here, there is no need to enter the email ID here, and just click on the next button. It is the warning message saying that you have not provided an email address. Do you want to remain uninformed of critical security issues in your configuration? Yes, it doesn't matter. Just click on the next button again. Okay, this is the second screen, that is download software updates. So there is no need to download any software updates, skip software updates, just click on the next button. And accept the default selection, that is install database software only, means we are installing only software, we are not creating any database. SAP installer will create the database when we start the ECC 6.0 HP6 IDAS installation. Okay, just click on the next button. And it is single instance database installation, that is we are not using any real application clusters. Just accept the default selection, that is single instance database installation. Click on the next. And English language, click on the next. Enterprise Edition, it needs 3.53 GB space in the hard drive. Just click on the next. And this is the Oracle base and software location is C:\Oracle/E6D is the identifier which you have given in the black screen, that is DOS prompt. And 11.203, that means 11.2.0.3 is the version, Oracle version. Just click on the next. It checks the prerequisite checks, means it will check the swap size and physical RAM and architecture, environment variables, etc., etc. And it is the summary. So this is the summary is displayed here. And you can just click on the install button to continue the installation. Hardly it takes 5 to 10 minutes time for completion of this installation. Just wait and watch. So all the steps are completed successfully. It's stopped at finish. Just click on the close button to close this universal installer. So now the Windows server has been configured with prerequisite softwares, that is J2 SDK and Oracle, and configuration of page file also done, and computer name is configured with fully qualified domain name. So now you are ready to install ECC 6.0 EHP 6 IDA software on this particular server. So I will continue the experiment in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions on this particular experiment, you can leave your comments in my website, that is www.punarvasi.com, or you can leave your comment on this particular video using this below form. Thanks for watching.